Hello? Hello? Jerry, is that you? Jerry, it's you, isn't it? Oh, you son of a bitch. Jerry, fuck you. Where are you? Did you get out? You know what, goddammit? If you're gonna call me, you might as well say something, because all you do this way is freak me out. You know what? I don't need this shit. Fucking hard leg. I can call the cops, you know. Oh, they trace it to you, you're busted back direct, you know? I got a gun.
Excuse me. Started right after he got out. You gotta be careful, this guy's dangerous.
I know it. I can't believe they let him out. But he would have killed somebody there and thrown away the key.
Well, you're gonna give somebody else a chance in there, or what?
Been so lucky.
If he comes by, you can't let him in.
We don't come by.
Yeah, I was thinking.
Yeah, it's been 2 years.
Maybe you should get bars on your windows.
Oh, great. You can just throw peanuts at me to catch in my mouth. Like,
you get an attack down.
I can take care of myself.
He's not going to be sad.
Not an next one.
I do need a dog.
Can you use
the phone? Sure.
I'm not an axe murderer.
I didn't really think you were.
Oh, okay.
There's a voice
there. There
you
go.
Oh, no.
A big dyke named the voice, all right?
You're very beautiful.
What is going on over there?
Huh? I said you're very beautiful.
It sounds like the end of the world.
Thank you.
He said what? Speak up. Are you all right?
I'm sorry if I embarrassed
you. I don't believe another fucking hand on
your hand. I just don't take compliments real well.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
I gotta go. Some guy grabbed the voice or squeezed something and she slapped him, so he threatened her or some shit. I hate to eat one. Saddle up, turn it up.
I changed my mind.
What's the matter?
Nothing. I'll just go for it.
Will you call me? I'll see you at work.
No, call me.
All right.
Call me.
Yeah. And we'll do something this week.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Try to get him to have a drink. And if you get really, really nervous, you can just come to the party, right?
Party? You're gonna be like kicking some guy's ass when
I'm not gonna kick anybody's ass.
You known each other a while?
A few years, I guess.
I just met her tonight.
Are you sure you don't want to drink? People don't drink make me nervous.
Yeah, I make people nervous anyway.
Why's that?
Because I pick up on things, I think. That makes people uncomfortable.
Pick up on things?
Things not apparent.
Talent.
Mm-hmm.
What do you pick up on from me?
You're lonely. Not that much.
That hardly makes you Jean Dixon.
Who's Jean Dixon?
That woman. You know. That psychic. That woman who said to, Teddy Kennedy that Jack could get shot. What?
I'd like to see you again.
How do you mean?
See you again, what I said.
I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, I don't party like this every night or nothing, so don't be...
No, concerned. I just wanted to see you.
Why?
Just want people like to see each other. I mean, I don't want anything weird.
Man's the last thing I need.
I don't want to go to bed with you.
Well, don't butter me up or nothing.
Yeah, I'm not good for much, anyway.
How you mean?
Women aren't really my bag.
You a homo?
I'm not anything, really. I'm done with that. I'm just looking for a friend.
You a con?
Oh, ma'am.
Wow, don't call me ma'am. Makes me feel like your mom.
You're not old enough to be my mother.
Good.
She's dead, anyway.
All right.
She's been dead a long time.
Doesn't sound like you're smoking all day.
I'm from Beaver.
Oh, we're all from Beaver, ain't we?
Pardon?
Skip it.
It's up in the panhandle. My dad's a preacher up there.
Yeah, what kind of church?
Doesn't have a church.
Well, where does he meet his people?
He doesn't have any, really.
Huh. Here, I meant to take that piece of shit down and kind of got to where I like it.
There's stuff in it.
Stuff?
Hidden stuff.
You mean like a... What do you mean?
People and things. If you really look at it, you gotta look at it hard enough, you'll see it.
That's weird.
You hear that?
No, I don't hear nothing.
Listen.
You're hearing things. Substitute.
What is that? Yeah.
The goddamn cricket. Can you tell where it's coming from?
Sounds like it's...
It's over here, right?
No.
If you find it, don't kill it. It's bad luck.
Why is that, do you think?
Some smart ass cricket probably made it up. It's in the bathroom.
Really?
Yeah. I've seen it.
It's out here.
Where?
I don't know. Up there.
The smoke alarm. Battery's probably dead. Can get it?
Nope.
We'll kill the son of a bitch. Not bad luck to kill a smoke alarm.
I need something.
Here you go.
Nope. get rid of that.
How come?
They're dangerous. They have americium-241 in them.
What's that?
It's an element, a radioactive element.
No shit.
More radioactive than plutonium.
Jesus, no wonder I feel so lousy all the time.
Yeah. Here.
What are you doing?
Oh, just... Okay, then. I should go.
Where do you live?
I'm kind of between addresses right now.
Does that mean you don't got a place?
Oh, I got a place to stay.
Where?
Nowhere. Just where I stay.
If you want, you can stay here tonight. Sleep on the couch.
I don't want to put you out.
Somebody sleeping on the couch when I'm sleeping is not putting me out.
Okay, that'd be nice.
Crappy sofa.
Nice of you. Do you mind if I sleep on the floor?
Sleep yourself. Making coffee.
You're welcome. How you stand that dinky little shower? I could barely get under it. I ain't mad you didn't come down to Stringtown to meet me when I got out. But you might at least been ready for me back here. Shit, it don't even look like you knew I was coming.
I didn't.
Wrote you a letter, you didn't get my letter?
No.
You look good, you lost weight.
Not really.
Yeah, you did. Got anything sweet around here? Oreos or something? I got a sweet tooth, you know? Oreos, graham cracker. I was gonna get you some flowers.
Jerry, get out.
Oh, I just got here. I got some business to clear up down in Hilton. It's gonna take me a week or two. Then I'll be back up. I ain't got a whole lot of shit, so you don't have to go rearranging the furniture or anything. Hey, you ain't seen Mickey, have you? I hear he's looking for me.
He get his pearl, too?
He did this time.
He's an egg-sucking son of a bitch.
He might show up here.
No, he won't.
Yeah, I know you two have always been a little bit sweet on each other. I don't think I didn't notice that. Because I did. I saw it. The looks, you know, touches.
Is that why you ratted him out?
Yeah. It is so fucking dark in here, isn't it? Still snorting this shit?
Apparently.
No wonder you got so goddamn skinny.
I didn't get skinnier, you just got fatter.
Oh, you crack me up. You still working at that honky-tonk?
You know I am.
Still running with that little queer gal?
Her name's R.C.
R.C., yeah. R.C. You ain't gonna queer on me now, are you?
You better believe it.
Because you know what'd happen if I really thought that.
Don't you threaten me. I'd get another fucking court order if I thought I'd do anything.
Oh, you shouldn't have done that.
You knocked my door down.
You wouldn't open it.
I don't have to.
I ain't interested in this history, Aggie. I got bigger fish to fry.
You tried to kill me.
That was a rough one, yeah. I was bad to drink back then.
Oh, back before you found God?
Who was that boy up in here last night?
You been watching my place.
I saw him leave.
Calling me 8 times a day.
I fucking called you once.
Right.
Who was he?
Nobody.
Nobody. Just nobody leaving at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Must have spent the night.
Must have spent the night.
Did I do something wrong?
I don't know. Did you?
You're ridiculous.
Huh? Did you do something wrong?
Gosh, don't do that.
I ain't doing nothing.
I just don't want to go back over all
I ain't going back over nothing. I'm starting to get the feeling that maybe you ain't too happy to see me, girl. I missed you. Didn't you miss me?
Can't say I did, no.
I waited 2 years for this.
Don't give me that.
No, it's the God's honest truth. I've been waiting 2 years for this shit for you. You ain't getting shy on me, are you? Well, we're gonna have to get over that.
You know what, boss? I can't tell if you're fucking serious with this shit. I hate you. Oh, God, I wish to Christ I had just taken Lloyd and gone out to San Diego.
I was really looking forward to seeing you. You know not to mention his fucking name around me. I ain't the one who lost him! Now whose fucking fault is it you got slapped, huh?
Mine.
It's fucking wife's fault. Now you got some time to get your ducks in line before I come back here. Maybe by the next time I come home. You'd be a little bit nicer to me, you hear me? Huh? We can have a civilized conversation. Hear me talking to you
again.
Peter Evans.
Peter Evans. Okay. Where's your purse, Aggie?
It's under the bed.
so much. I'll see you real soon.
Maybe a couple of those aspirin.
Can I have a couple for my tooth?
Thanks for helping me.
I didn't really do anything.
Where'd you go? I woke up and I thought you...
I went to get some food. I hope you don't mind. I took the key.
Oh, that's all right.
Who was that guy?
My ex. Nut. Could you maybe make me a vodka and coke? I don't have to work tonight.
How long were you married?
Long enough to still get scared at night.
Do you have any kids?
No.
I don't like that guy. I don't like that he hit you.
I can't say I'm wild about it myself.
He said he's coming back here.
Eventually.
Maybe you need some kind of security.
I can take care of myself.
Why do you get scared tonight?
I was just kidding.
You should be scared.
How come?
People can do things to you, things you don't even know about.
Like what?
They try to control you, they try to force you to act a certain way. They can drive you crazy, too. I shouldn't talk about it. I don't know if it's safe or not.
I think we're pretty safe here.
No. Not really. You're never really safe. One time, maybe a long time ago, people were safe, but that's all over. Not anymore, not on this planet. We'll never really be safe again. We can't be. Not with all the technology, the chemicals, the information.
I don't like to think about that.
Sometimes, though, when you're lying in bed at night, you can feel it. All the machines, people working their machines, the works humming. I don't like to go on about it because it freaks people out. I wish I didn't think about it either, but they don't let you forget. They want you to know they're there.
But what's there? The machines?
Nothing makes them happier than knowing people are aware the machines are up and running.
Some pretty wild shit.
Yeah, I know you hate me.
Think I hate you?
I don't know.
I don't hate you.
Okay.
Why do you think I hate you?
I don't know.
I wouldn't let you stay here if I hated you.
Well, I guess that's right. I guess that's right.
Well, we're friends.
We are?
I don't have a lot of friends, but the ones I have, I'm real good too.
But you don't trust me.
Why do you say that?
You lied to me about having children.
How'd you know that?
I told you I pick up on stuff.
Well, I didn't lie. I don't have children. I had one.
What happened?
I lost him.
He died?
No, he disappeared.
Really?
Yeah, in the grocery store. 10 years ago now.
How old was he?
6. Do you have any more questions? Because if you do ask him that, I don't want to talk about it again.
What was his name?
Lloyd.
When did you stop looking for him?
A couple years ago. Except in my sleep. I still look for him in my sleep.
Do you ever?
No. I did lie about one thing. I do get scared at night. If you want, you can stay here again.
Okay.
It's kind of nice having somebody around, you know? I'm different.
I haven't been to bed with a woman for a long time, but I think I could go to bed with you.
Come here, boy.
Second ago, it's like a bed bug or some shit.
Maybe you killed it.
No, I had it between my fingers, but it squiggled out.
Go back to the sheet and find it.
Man, little fucker, I was just about to fall asleep.
I don't see it.
There.
What?
Right there.
Where?
There.
Where?
There, you see it?
What?
Right there.
This?
No, this. That there.
Well,
there, right there. I guess it's right there.
Yeah, what's
that? Do you see it?
Well, I don't know.
Right there. It's really small.
I guess. What is that?
It's a fucking bug.
No, I know that. What kind of bug?
Like an aphid?
An aphid?
An aphid, it's like a,
a bed bug?
No. Well, yeah, kind of. More like a louse.
Louse?
Lice. Not like head lice. More like plant lice.
Or like termite.
No, that's more like a thrip.
Thrip?
Like a termite.
Do you mean tick?
No, a tick's like a flea. Thrip's like a termite.
What's a bed bug like?
A bed bug.
No, I mean, what is a bed bug?
A bed bug.
I thought that was a nickname.
This is an aphid.
Plant lice.
I think so.
And they bite?
This one sure did.
Maybe it's not really an orchid or whatever.
Aphid.
fucking schmafid, whatever. Did you just kill it? I can get some sleep. Oh, that showed him.
Hold on. Get up.
Come on.
There might be more.
God, there's not any more. We would have seen them.
You almost didn't see that one.
Well, it was very small.
That's my point, Agnes. They're small. You may not have seen them.
Oh, jeez.
Look at my wrist. I'm gonna wake up in the morning and find this.
This morning, I'm awake. Sort of. Do they travel in packs or something? Well, if there's one, do you have reason to suspect there's others with them?
Makes sense. And you're assuming it's him. Some rogue aphid on his travels instead of some matriarchal type with a big brood somewhere.
Matriarchal?
You ever watch Big Valley?
Sure.
Barbara Stanwyck?
Mm-hmm.
Like her?
No. Birds learn to talk like that anyway.
School. I was homeschooled.
Oh, shit.
My father didn't believe in school.
He's done a pretty good job throwing around words like matriarchal.
Well, I learned that from Big Valley. This is clean.
You got a nice body.
So do you.
Better looking with that clothes on it.
I agree.
You know, some people look nice and then you see them naked and they're a big disappointment.
Yeah.
Why'd you say you weren't one for the ladies?
That's true.
Could have fooled me.
You're different.
How am I different?
You don't speak the codes.
How long has it been since you was with a woman?
I don't know, a few years, I guess.
Must have gotten a bad one.
No, I just decided it wasn't worth it anymore.
What wasn't?
You have a center, right? A place inside of you that's just you, that hasn't been spoiled. And I think it's really important to try and keep that space sacred in some sense, on some level. But sex or relationships cloud that space. Or it cloud me, I guess, and make it difficult to be just me and not have to worry about being somebody else. Sound like a big asshole, don't I?
Not at all. I like hearing you talk.
Aren't you gonna answer it?
No.
Why not?
Goss.
You were Goss once. Hello? Hello?
Gosh, right?
I don't think so.
What'd they say?
Just static. There you go. See?
Where?
There.
I'm sorry, where?
Right there.
We'll squish him.
There you go again. How do you know it's not the super mother aphid and she's carrying a million eggs?
Oh, what are plant lice doing in my place?
Biting me, for one thing.
You know what? I gotta get this place sprayed.
I'll do it. I'll buy some stuff tomorrow.
Fuck that. It's their room. They should pay for it.
But someone might have to come in here.
Goddamn right they will.
Well, you do what you want, but I wouldn't.
How come?
Never mind.
No way. How come?
I shouldn't say anything.
No what?
It's your place. I don't want to interfere.
Why wouldn't I want someone in my place? Because you're a con? Why didn't you just tell me when I asked
you? I've never been to prison. I've just got people after me. That's all.
Oh, you've just got people after you. Well, who?
I don't want to drag you into it.
Drag me into what?
Agnes, please.
Drag me
into it. I'm not comfortable telling you.
You don't trust me? You can trust me. I'm not going
to... I trust you. That's not it. I don't want you to get hurt.
I'll take my chances.
I won't.
So what? You're going? Where? You don't even got nowhere to go.
I'll be fine.
Oh, well, all right, then. Just fuck you. You know what, you may think it's easy for me to just take you in here, but I ain't the kind of woman who moves from man to man. Fact is, it's been quite a while since I even had anyone to get close to, you know what I'm saying? Not that I need a man. Oh, I need a man like I need a hole in the goddamn head, but I just get lonely sometimes, you know? It's kind of nice having somebody around for a change. It was different. Oh, you son of a bitch!
Got in some trouble with the army. I was stationed at Sakarka in the Syrian desert during the war, and these doctors, they kept coming in and giving us shots and pills. A lot of the guys were getting sick, with vomiting, diarrhea, migraines, blackouts, and I was having some weird thoughts, and I started feeling sick, so they shipped me home. They put me in this hospital at Groom Lake, and they started running these tests on me. And they had every kind of doctor you can imagine just probing and jabbing at me and asking me all these weird questions, feeding me more pills. Those fucking doctors were experimenting on me. I went AWOL. I was a lifer, too. I didn't have anywhere to go. And they don't respond too well to some drugged-up guinea pig just taking off. I don't know. And I'm not carrying a disease or a contagion. Oh, Jesus. that's how they start. Typhoid, Legionnaire's disease, the government screw up. AIDS with the fucking monkeys in Africa. They're after me. These people don't fuck around, Angus. I shouldn't have told you that, but I needed to tell somebody. And I trust you. I know we haven't known each other very long. I don't want to go. I don't want to go.
Thank you.
help you?
Heidi. No.
Agnes isn't here.
No shit. Where is she, Peter?
The liquor store, I think.
Damn, Peter. I think if I were a roach, I'd probably take a hint. Oh.
Where's the TV?
I don't think she has one.
We had one once. 19-inch RCA short touch tuner. I bought it with the money I made driving a sausage truck. I drove that truck 20 hours a day sometimes, just so I could feed my wife and my kid. You ever do anything like that? Who the fuck doesn't have a TV? How are you supposed to know what's going on in the world, man? Jesus, we could be invaded by Martians or some shit, you know? Fuck, they could be evacuating the whole goddamn city right now. And me and you be sitting here with our thumbs up our ass.
Could be.
Who got this stuff out?
It is. The microscope.
Oh, shit. Well, you might want to put it back before Aggie gets home. She ain't gonna like it very much. What you working on, Peter?
Looking at something. Don't touch that, please. I'm looking at...
What are you looking at?
The bug. Excuse me.
The bug? Just a bug.
Mm. In my blood.
Oh, in your blood.
Mm.
Hey, you know, you remind me of somebody. You know who you remind me of? Do you know who you remind me of?
Who do I remind you of?
This guy I know in the pen.
In the pen?
Yeah.
Mm.
I just did a Deuce Farm robbery.
Wow.
Guy named Porterfield.
Mm.
You're not related to them, are you?
I don't believe so.
I don't believe so.
No.
You know what we called him? So do what you did know you call what him? We call him? We call him Mrs. Porterfield. You kind of remind me of him a little bit.
Oh.
What the fuck are we looking at?
A bug in my blood.
In your blood?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't see nothing.
It's very small.
Yeah, I bet it is. You're pretty much just jacking up here, aren't you? Why don't you answer me when I ask you a question or not?
Well, I thought that was a rhetorical question.
Oh. Did you know what I'd do to you if I were bugging? You were fucking with Agnes.
But I don't know who you are or what
you don't know who I am. Didn't we just meet in here a little while ago?
Yes.
And you forgot me that quick?
No.
Yeah, well, I remember who the fuck you are.
Right, my point is I don't want any trouble with you.
Yo, my point is you ain't gonna get no trouble from me. I'm staying here for a while. So you better find someplace else to be your fucking experiment.
I don't think you want to stay here.
Oh, yeah, why is that?
The place is crawling with these things.
Oh, right, with your little bugs.
We're infested.
I believe you are, Peter.
You let him in here?
He picked the lock.
Come here, girl.
Get
come here, girl.
Get out of here, Jerry.
You look good, baby. Mustache tickles a little bit.
It's okay.
Not mine, yours.
Jerry, you can't stay here.
Hey, wait a minute. I'm just going to be here for a little while. Hang my hat. What was the name of that girl you used to run with?
My voice.
I've been trying to remember that shit. I've been trying to think. She was a trip. Remember that time over at Mickey's? She laid up on the balcony and took a big old shit. Landed right on... You remember that shit? Landed on a cop car. That was the funniest shit I've ever seen.
It was the pork party.
Was that a fucking pork party? It was, wasn't it? Hey, you gotta remember the pork party,
you know,
baby.
What, Jerry?
Hey, Mickey had this pork. You know, like the can of pork, you know, like Spam or some shit like they give you in the army. That drunk son of a bitch starts throwing it all over the place. Next thing you know, end of the night, he's passed out on the fucking floor in the kitchen. Pot on his head. Pork dripping. I know that shit's some funny shit. It's fucking dripping all over his chest, and he can't get up. He starts, like, doing one of these numbers to the fucking linoleum and shit. It's so fucking greasy.
Jerry.
He can't. Wait a minute. It was
Jerry.
What?
Get out.
What, you throwing me out?
Now.
Well, I misunderstood.
Yeah.
You know, I was going to stay here for a while, but I guess that's a bad idea. What with you being infested with your little fucking bugs and shit? I gotta admit, though, I'm disappointed, Aggie. And you, I owe an apology, too. Here I was all this time thinking you was some fucking weirdo freeloading cokehead son of a bitch. I had no clue you were taking such good care of Aggie. That's important. I appreciate that. Thank you. I'll be around.
Can you believe him?
Man, look at this. I need you to look at this now, please.
Yeah, police department.
What? Ah! Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Ow!
Sorry, what are you doing?
I'm calling the police department.
Don't do that, okay?
Agnes, it's me and Eplane. He violated his parole. You can't fuck around with
him. No, it's not that easy.
Agnes,
not that easy.
Please.
Agnes.
Can you see it?
What?
You see the bug?
Yeah. Agnes.
Can you tell what it's doing?
Agnes.
No, it's
feeding.
Feeding on what?
My blood. It's feeding off my blood.
So you're saying it...
Jesus, I'm saying it's feeding off my blood. It's a parasite.
Well, we knew that.
No, we knew they were biting. Bugs bite for different reasons. See, these are biting for food.
None of this stuff's working? Well...
No, they're immune to the sprays. Thought they might be coke bugs. Didn't find any in Agnes's
coke stash. Bugs?
The bugs you sometimes find in cocaine.
There are no bugs in cocaine.
The DEA sprays the larvae on the coca plantations in South America and Central America. They're genetically engineered to survive the purification process. If they can't wipe out the drugs, they want to wipe out the users.
God.
You didn't know about this? That's hard to believe.
Thanks for telling me.
Well, they don't get to all of it. You don't have them. I told you, I checked. Believe me, if you haven't.
You've had them before?
You ask a lot of questions.
You know, maybe we should take this to a lab somewhere.
A lab?
Well, find out what it is.
I know what it is.
What is it?
It's a blood-sucking aphid.
Look,
and we're
in aphid
infested.
Business? You know,
okay?
I don't really... What's that?
It's a burrowing aphid.
Let
you have to dig it out.
Let me see it. Agnes? Let me see. Where?
Look, it's
where
right
there.
I don't see it.
That little spike
under
the
skin,
shit, Agnes.
What is really
why can't I see it?
I don't know. Why can't we see it?
Is it under the skin?
Yeah. Here, give me that thing. I'll dig it out and show you. You can see it better.
The place is crawling.
Oh, you know, when I talked to Carl...
Whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You talked to who?
Carl, the manager of the motel.
Why? Whose idea?
Just to tell him we were
infested. What? Why'd you tell him that, Agnes?
I tell him nothing that would get you into anything.
Just tell me exactly what you told him. Exactly.
Bugs, it's really weird.
Which is weird. So what are you saying?
I haven't seen
him. But us, it's just really weird.
You've already said that, Agnes.
Well, we saw a doctor.
Oh,
we had to check out this box.
Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. No. Okay, either you don't grasp the situation or you're just fucking me over. Okay?
No, I didn't say anything to him about you.
What kind of doctor?
He's a dermatologist.
What did he find?
No bugs.
He picked them up.
He said they didn't even look like bugs.
Would you please not talk while I address Agnes?
He gave me something for a rash.
Let me see it. No.
It's just a lotion, that's all. Here. I'm not dumb. I didn't say anything about you. I'm going to do that to you.
They got to you. God damn it. You're a part of this.
No, I'm just trying to make sense out
of
something.
Okay, you tell me. Do we have the bugs?
No, I'm just looking for some kind of an explanation.
Do we have bugs or not?
I don't know.
It's not a matter of opinion. An organism just... is or isn't.
Right.
So, are the bugs or aren't they?
Some.
No, not some bugs. Don't give me some bugs. Presence of bugs, absence of bugs. The sign outside says vacancies or no vacancies. It doesn't say possibility of vacancies. Now, do we have bugs or not?
Yeah.
And your doctor is lying to you.
Peter, do you have sores like hers?
His are worse. Show her. Show her, Peter.
Show me.
Oh, God, did you put something on that?
Oh, my God. You think an aphid did that?
I know it did it to me.
Aphids can't bite.
You know a lot about aphids?
No.
Do you know anything about aphids?
No.
We do.
Come on, y'all. Ronnie, you haven't even told Peter your news yet. They got custody of the voice's kid. Isn't that great?
Mm.
Ronnie's going to be an aunt or a mother.
Okay,
or whatever. I never thought that.
Listen
to
me. There are no bugs. There are no bugs in this microscope. There's no bugs on your skin, in your skin, in this room. There are no fucking bugs.
Odd, actually.
I was with the doctor, Peter. Agnes, tell him what he told you.
No, I don't
he said
think we can talk about it
like that she did it to herself just like you, or maybe you did it to her.
Oh, you think I would do that to her?
I don't know what your deal is. I don't know who the fuck you are or what you're about, but all I know is I regret bringing you in here. I can't do nothing about you, but suggest that you get some serious fucking medical attention. But I can do something about my friend, and by God, I intend
to.
You even try to stop me, and I'll introduce you to an old friend of yours.
What does that mean?
Who? Somebody's been asking about you.
Who?
Dr. Sweet.
Who's Dr. Sweet? What are you talking about?
Yeah, think about what your
you know
friend's
what I'm talking
doing.
About.
Yeah, I do. Through and late. Your friend is going to turn me in.
Tell me what? Somebody's been asking about Peter at the bar.
What did he tell you?
Not much, but apparently I didn't know you were staying here, so maybe I should have asked some more questions, but he's obviously not somebody good to meet, or he would have known where to find you, Peter.
Quit playing games. Tell him I'm not playing, Agnes.
You know what? She would never do that. She would never
try
do that,
me.
Peter. She wouldn't. No, you don't mean it.
Try me.
I don't mean it.
Stunned that you think I would try to stop Agnes from going with you. I'm only staying here because I was invited. I don't stay where I'm not wanted. I wouldn't attempt to keep somebody where they don't want to be. Agnes is an adult, and she is free to do as she pleases.
I thought you'd say it, though.
As for Dr. Sweet, tell him what you wish. I have no doubt he already knows who I am.
Right.
But as for your contention, there are no bugs. I disagree.
You're going to stay with me for a while. I want you to pack it back. Agnes, Ryan. Look at me. I want you to pack it back.
Lloyd out there. Get away from Ross. She invited us. But I waited too late. Who knows, she probably hates me now, too. I can't believe Mercy did that to me. I can't imagine what I did to make her hate me so much. Fuck, I don't believe I didn't see it coming sooner, son, little bitch. I don't know why I love you so much. I don't hardly know you, truth be told, and we ain't even done that much in bed except that one night, and I don't care. Things all we ever talk about is bugs. I guess I'd rather talk with you about bugs than nothing with nobody. Not that I got much to say, unless I talk about misery. Who wants to hear that? I don't. I just get so sick of it. A lousy life, laundromats and grocery stores and dumb marriages and lost kids. Lord, he's the only good time.
That's it. You're the only ones. No one else in this motel has bugs.
Yeah?
Yes, they're my bugs. I brought them here. They come from me.
You mean on your clothes?
Under my skin. There's a egg sack under my skin.
Egg sack?
That's why they didn't grab me.
God, well, where did it come from in the first place?
The eggs are under my skin. They hatch. They need air. They come out. They need food. They come back. They eat.
Yeah. Well, no, what do you mean?
Think about it.
No. Oh. It wouldn't have done that to you.
Well, you got to do it to a pig. You have to try it on a human to see if it works.
You're a U.S. soldier. It wouldn't have done that to you.
The government wouldn't conduct experiments on their own people.
No.
Like feeding LSD to enlisted men at Edgewood Arsenal or sitting around watching the poor fuckers in Tuskegee die from syphilis. Why don't you fucking wake up?
Where is this egg sack? What are you doing? Oh, oh my God, Peter! Oh, my God!
Stop it!
Oh,
the sack's in my tooth.
Oh, God, it's impossible.
My egg is too filled at the base. This is District Sons of Bitches put an insect egg sack under the filling.
Hey, maybe we got us a little bit of my problem here.
They're eating me!
I know. I'm just trying to play that devil's advocate thing
okay,
here, okay?
Okay.
Maybe you're looking for a connection to the army, so you're just more...
Both likely to hear me out.
You have no idea what these people are capable of.
You're...
I'm not a child. I know who I am.
Father, God, let's go.
It's not safe. We'll be watched too closely, Agnes, okay? They haven't grabbed me yet because they want to see how the experiment turns out.
You cannot know that!
White residence? I'm looking for Peter Evans. I was told to find him here. I have it on good authority that Peter is staying here. I don't mean any harm. If I could just talk to Peter. Can I speak with you for a moment? I assure you I'm here with the best of intentions. All right. Thank you.
Sweet, all of my credentials are in there.
Oh, you couldn't
get to listen to the man.
Why don't you wait outside? Give us some time alone. Bug problem?
You should know.
I should? What are they?
Aphids.
Aphids.
Look around, asshole. They're in right now. They like to go in sometimes.
And the tinfoil?
Scrambles the signal.
You're receiving a signal?
Transmitting.
You're transmitting a signal?
Not me, the bugs.
The bugs have a transmitter.
The bugs are the transmitter.
And the tinfoil scrambles the signal.
Help.
I'm sure it does. Peter Evans has been incarcerated in an army hospital for 4 years.
I know.
He's been diagnosed as a delusional paranoid with schizophrenic tendencies. Well, personally, I'm not a big fan of labels. His doctors believe he's potentially dangerous to himself. Or even others.
Aren't you his doctor?
More of a consultant, really.
He told me about you. He said you got a kick out of it, like some Nazi.
Got a kick out of it?
Your experiments.
My experiments. So now he's being hunted by the Army, the CIA. And you think they'd send a doctor to find him? I'm here on my own.
Because you care about Peter so much.
Yes, I do. Know why he was institutionalized?
No.
No. You wouldn't. May I have a drink?
No, you can't.
How often do you hit that thing?
Often as I like.
May I?
Suit yourself. And be careful.
I'm okay.
Yeah, you're also sitting on 20 gallons of high test.
Can only imagine what this is for. Don't see a jet ski in here. Bugs are a fairly common delusion among paranoids. Bugs, spiders, snakes. Spiders. You haven't had any snakes, have you?
They're the first.
Have you at least entertained the idea that the bugs are a delusion?
Well, I know you're not a delusion.
Touché. No delusion. Where do the bugs come from?
Peter.
How's that work?
You injected them.
I injected them. Right. When did you first see the bugs?
When they got here.
He saw them first?
They're his bugs.
Yes, they are. And when I take them away, the bugs will disappear. You want the bugs to disappear.
But I can handle it. We're winning the fight.
Really? The bugs are retreating?
No, but we can find the egg sacs now and cut them out of his body.
You keep up that cutting, there might not be much left of Peter. For you or for me.
I know what I'm doing.
Being watched. I could talk to them. They'd listen to me. Peter comes in out of the cold. First thing I do, I'll get him in surgery so they can cut out those eggs.
Egg sacs.
Egg sacs. Simple procedure. Under the proper conditions with a trained medical staff.
They'll put him back in the hospital. They'll take him away from me.
No, they won't. I won't let them.
You can do that?
I'm his doctor. He's my project.
Yes.
I don't want to see him locked up. I want to help him.
Why would you stop what you started?
We made a mistake. I made a mistake. I didn't realize. I didn't know what they were using it for. What they're doing? It's dangerous. It's wrong. Have them call me. Let me take them in. Because if you leave it in their hands, I can't vouch for Peter's chances.
Why are they doing this?
It's what they do.
I can't trust you.
Yes, you can. I can do something for you. I can help you. Your son, Lloyd,
What do you know about Lloyd?
I can help you find Lloyd.
You know about Lloyd?
I shouldn't say anything else.
No, if you know something about my son, you have to tell me.
Don't watch. If I say too much, they might hurt him. You don't like that, do you?
No.
Help you? Bring Peter in, and I'll help you find Lloyd.
Oh, Peter! Peter, Lloyd!
Peter.
He's alive!
Good Lord.
Sound card's good. What do you run on?
You need your meds.
New model.
We need to talk.
Do you know him?
Talk to one another.
Do you know him?
He knows me. It's all right.
Munitions, R&D. Nice work.
What's happening?
You believe it.
He'll bring me Lloyd.
She's not part of this.
It'll tell you anything you want to hear, Agnes.
This is between you and me.
That's how it's programmed.
It's always been you and me.
I don't understand. I don't understand.
I'll show you. It only knows what they program it to say. Okay? No, shut up! They can't wait for me to come outside. They come to collect me. The experiment is over. They come to pick up their petri dish, and they send a machine to do it. Agnes, it is a fucking machine. You can see for yourself. They're sending a machine.
Okay. I don't really understand. You have to explain to me what is going on, Peter.
Listen. If you want to know what is going on, you have to listen to me. You have to. Because you don't know the fucking enormity of what we're dealing with.
May the 29th, 1954, a consortium of bankers, industrialists, corporate CEOs, and politicians held a series of meetings over 3 days at the Bilderberg Hotel in Oosterbeek, Holland. They drew up a plan for maintaining the status quo. It's the way things are. It's the rich get richer, the poor get poorer. They devised a plan to manipulate technology, economics, the media, population control, world religion, to keep things the way they are. And they have continued to meet once a year, every year, since the original meeting. Look it up.
Okay.
Under their orders, the CIA had smuggled Nazi scientists into the States to work with the American military at Kaufman, developing an inter-epidermal tracking microchip.
What?
It's a surveillance tool. It's a computer chip that has been implanted in the skin of every human being born on the planet since 1982. The test group for the prototype was the People's Temple. And when the Reverend Jim Jones threatened to expose them, he and every member of his church were assassinated.
Oh,
but it's not enough just to track people to spy on them. They want control.
Yeah.
So they create the intelligence, manned, interface, biochip, a subcutaneous transponder, a computer chip imprinted with living brain cells. They needed lab rats to test it, and they found us. Me, in the Gulf, and another soldier working at Calspan at the time, Tim McVeigh.
Oh, wait.
They turned us into fucking zombies. Remote control assassins. And then they picked him up, chucked him in the prison factory, but I found my chip and I cut it out.
Oh,
so they sent me back to the lab for further testing and a new experiment.
You're John Doe number two.
No. That's who they want me to be. That is the flaw in the IMI biochip. They can't get to everybody. People slip through the cracks. They find the chip. They cut it out. Like me or Ted Kaczynski. They need a chip that will self-perpetuate. That will spread like a virus. That people can pass to each other. To everyone. They got it!
Oh, you mean the bugs. They got the bugs.
A living, breathing organism.
Oh, my God!
An ultimate parasite implanted by a queen bug, the supermother, who mates with the drone, lays egg sacs in the body of the host, and governs a growing army of rapidly multiplying, brainwashing bugs.
They gave those things to you, and you gave them to me. You gave those fucking things to me!
Maybe.
What? Well, of course you did!
Agnes! I don't believe that my presence here is accidental.
What?
You do know. Put it together. The pieces will fit.
Okay? No, they don't fit.
You have to look harder.
Why, you didn't think I've been fucking looking. They don't fit. I don't know.
You have to look harder. You have to.
I don't see it. What are you trying to get?
Come on.
I don't know where to start.
Start at the beginning.
We were in the grocery store. I took him to the grocery store, and we were shopping, and he was right there in the cart, and I went back to get an onion because I forgot the onion, and I just turned away, and then he was gone, and then he was just gone.
No, he was just gone. No.
He couldn't get out in just a few seconds.
So he couldn't have gotten out.
No, he didn't get out. He got somebody took him. Somebody took my boy because
somebody.
I was...
Somebody.
Well, yeah, no, not anybody because he was smart. He wouldn't have talked to strangers. I told him not to talk to strangers, and he was smart.
So then it had to be.
It had to be somebody that he knew. It had to be somebody that he knew that he wasn't as scared of like his daddy. It was his daddy. God took him. You guys took him, and the police couldn't help me, and I tried so hard, and they couldn't help me. No matter what. They wouldn't help me. They wouldn't help me, the police and the FBI, because they paid guns to take him. They paid guns to take him, and he gave them to them. He gave them to them.
Okay, get another piece. Get another piece.
Oh, God, R.C. was here. R.C. was here, and she left because she was spying on you, and she was spying on us. No, and you brought the bugs. The bugs were under your skin and the X-Acts, and you brought the... And
I
RC,
brought the bugs.
R.C. brought you. R.C. brought you, and then you brought the bugs, and then R.C. brought the bugs.
Yes!
R.C. brought the bugs. Oh, fucker, R.C. brought the bugs. And then Goss got out of jail, and they let him out of jail, and he wasn't supposed to get out, and they gave him this early parole, and he came here, and...
Just when I showed up.
Because they sent him. Because they sent him. They let him out early to send him here. He made it here. We got him early poor. And they let him out to send him because of the bugs, to track the bugs, to check on the bugs, to watch their progress. Right. And R.C. told us that there weren't any bugs, but R.C. brought the bugs. Right. They made her bring the bugs. Oh, the boy, LaVoice's little boy, the kid. They gave him the kid. They never looked on that. A couple of fucking queers. They wanted to get on that kid. And they made her bring me the bugs to give me, to give them the kid. Mm-hmm. And then, but wait. No, you never had bugs before you got here. They had you all that time. They did all those things to you, and you never had no bugs until you got here, until after. They gave you the, what they call that, the drone. They gave you the drone. And they gave me the queen. They gave me the mother. And that's when they came out. That's when they mated, when we made them. Oh, my God, and it had to be me. It had to be me from the very beginning because they took Lloyd. They took him somewhere. They took him to this laboratory, and they cut him open, and the stuff matched or whatever, the DNA and the blood and all of it together. And so they started to build the queen, the mother, and they gave it to me. The juice, the bug, the mother, the bug, the super mother bug. I am the super mother bug. I am the super mother bug. Oh my God. We made them. We made them. We gave birth to them. And they will never leave us. They will never leave us because we made them. And those people are trying to come in here to kill us because the bugs won't go out into the world to do their work. They would never leave us. They will never leave us. We are all they know. And they're trying to come in here to kill us, to send the bugs back out into the world. Oh my God. Oh, my God, you know what we have to do? You know what we have to do? We have to kill him.
Yes. It's better. No one.
Oh, we have to kill him. No. We have responsibility. What is it?
Who is it?
Pizza Harris.
I can order a pizza.
You order a pizza?
No. Just leave it.
You got to pay me, lady.
How much is it?
$14.74.
What's on it?
Everything.
Everything.
Everything. Everything. Want change?
No. Just take it.
Yeah, whatever.
If we don't open the door, they'll know we know.
Hey! No.
No. Hold it.
Thank you.